With WKUF News, I'm David Jackson for Wednesday, April 27th, 2016. New funding to address the water situation could be coming from Washington. Ron Fonger of the Flint Journal reports that U.S. Senators Debbie Stabenow and Gary Peters announced today that a funding package for Flint has been included in the Water Resource Development Act. A recent amendment that could have sent funding to Flint was dropped from an energy bill in Washington amid outcries from Flint residents blaming the Michigan senators for failing at their job. The new funding package has been built into a bill that the U.S. Senate Environment and Public Works Committee is expected to consider this week. Senator Stabenow said in a statement that she is pleased that a new path has been found to get urgently needed help to families in Flint and other communities across the country, adding that this is an important step and says that she will not give up until it gets done. A Michigan State Senate committee has approved legislation to drop Common Core. Brian McVicker on MLive.com reports that under the legislation, Michigan would instead adopt standards most recently used by Massachusetts, whose public schools have been regarded as some of the top performers in the nation. Senator Patrick Kolbeck of Canton, the bill's sponsor, says that the Common Core curriculum is a veritable race to the middle in terms of student achievement, and defended the potentially new curriculum, saying that it is designed to get the state's public school systems to the top echelon. Supporters of the Common Core standard, on the other hand, defended the curriculum, saying that schools have simply not used the system long enough for results to take hold. Passing the Senate committee is a crucial step in passing the legislation. However, no set date has been scheduled for the full Senate to vote on the bill. Google, along with four other companies, have joined forces to lobby lawmakers and regulators in Washington to push through self-driving cars. Computerworld.com reports that the tech giant, Ford, Volvo, and two ride-sharing services have formed the Self-Driving Coalition for Safer Streets, with the mission of spurring federal lawmakers to bypass state lawmakers in creating legislation to regulate these robot cars. The coalition's spokesman, David Strickland, former head of the NHTSA, says that self-driving vehicle technologies will make America's roadways safer and less congested. And the Obama administration is apparently on board with the coalition's plans, having earmarked nearly $4 billion over 10 years to govern the technology and its use on U.S. roads. From another perspective, TechCrunch.com reports that driverless trucking is right around the corner in Europe, with ostensibly only regulatory matters standing in the way. Recent tests in Europe conducted by six of their largest manufacturers have seen autonomous trucks making their way across the continent in convoys. The benefits to driverless trucking, according to TechCrunch.com, are said to be safer roads, better fuel mileage, cheaper costs for shipping, and the ability for loads to arrive, in some cases, faster, since robot drivers have the ability to drive 24 hours a day without having to stop for rest. With nearly 9 million people employed by the trucking industry, however, regulators stand in the way of universal deployment, saying that the technology would likely mean the end of millions of jobs. Wilfried Achenbach, Senior Vice President of Engineering and Technology for Daimler Chrysler, said in an interview in 2015 that software today is far from being able to handle the complex calculations and decisions that the brain can handle, adding that the current technology is designed for open highway operation on pre-programmed routes with a driver at the wheel as a precaution. Google has recently tested their autonomous vehicles on city streets. However, in February, a Google test car famously got into a crash with a bus after apparently the bus driver did not know what the car was going to do next. Currently, each individual state is responsible for regulating autonomous vehicles for their own jurisdictions. However, the coalition headed by Google is lobbying Congress now to usurp the individual states' rights in order to push forward with their new technology. For more information about today's stories, visit WKUF.fm. I'm David Jackson.